Today I have with me the Srixon Z65 family of irons, and I'm going to make an apology right now if I get any of the numbers mixed up here, because trust me, it is not that straightforward if you're trying to speak and talk about them. You've got three models in here. You've got the 565, the 765, and the 965, and these replace the 945, 745, and 545 irons with the previous one. So the five is the first number, is the model number. The middle number is the year. So this was really 2016 they were announced, and previous models are 2014. And the last one, I think, just put five in there for the hell of it. There are three particular models. I'm going to start with the highest one, which is the 965, and that is the bladed model. Now, these are very similar to the previous 945 models. And the difference with these, as is pretty much the difference with all of them, is that the muscle that's on the back of the iron is moved a little bit more towards the toe. And that is there to increase the forgiveness, because if you get some more weight out towards the toe, it's going to stop it twisting as much during impact, which then should give you a better and more solid strike. So let's see if that is the case. When you put the bladed version down at address, it does look pretty compact, just as you would expect a normal bladed iron to be. These are forged from 1020 carbon steel, so they should feel pretty good. And that is just your classic blade. I mean, it's quite a sharp feel. I wouldn't say it's necessarily majorly forgiving, but it is a good feel, you know. And as these irons go, or as forged blades go rather, I think this is right up there as a good quality forged blade. I don't think really this is for a lot of golfers, even sort of low handicap golfers. It's maybe part of the set you might consider the wedge if you're an elite player. So I'm just going to move on up to the next model in the range, which is the 765. Okay, so this is like a semi cavity backed wedge. Try not to say that after a couple of drinks. And what you're going to get here is a slightly larger head. It's got a little bit more offset in the wedge here. We've got a fairly closed sort of cavity, but it sits very well at address. And to me, for you getting a good nice setup, not too much offset, and a nice generous sized head. And really, this is what I love about these types of irons. It's just a perimeter weighted forged iron, no inserts, no nonsense going on, and it just delivers a great feel, which is what you want from a forged iron, but with a modicum of forgiveness on it as well. I'm just going to pop on up to the 8 iron here. Now forgive me, I've got the 7 instead. We're going to go straight to 7, because that's the type of thing that we do here. So the 7, again, it's a very similar sort of style. Sole features the same V-sole across all three models. And this is new. It's something you will have seen on the RTX 3 wedges. And what it is they will list it on the site as having two bounces. So there's a leading edge bounce, a trailing edge bounce. I wouldn't pay too much attention to this. Bounces are not a great deal different from what you would probably normally expect on a normal iron in terms of the overall bounce of the club. What it does do is that it goes to the turf more easily. Certainly that is my experience. It does go through the ground very well indeed. I think with the wedges, sometimes in the sand, it didn't give you enough bounce. But I think when you're playing from grass, particularly firmer surfaces like this, it's really very good. The other thing they've done with the sole, which I quite like, is they got rid of that step that they used to have in the heel of all the clubs. And now it's just a more normal, smooth transition from the hosel into the sole of the club. And I think it looks a lot better, and it certainly plays a lot better as well. Now I'm going to move up to the 6 iron. I've done a lot of launch monitor testing, and I'm going to switch into the 565 for the 6 iron. Now what this gives you is a proper cavity back, if you like. There is a holodeck cavity, you can look into it. The head size is a little bit bigger. It's got a slightly more offset than the 6 iron in the 765. But why I've gone to this in this particular club is that when I was testing these clubs, I said to the tester that Well, that's really good. I presume I've got the 765. You went, no, you've got the 565. I went, well, come on, don't be stupid. Give me the 765. And I hit them on the launch monitor. And the variation in distance through my best and my worst was around about 10 yards. With the 565, that cut it down to about 3 to 4 yards. Now, clearly, you can't have an iron that's varying by as much as 10 yards. And that shows you what forgiveness gives you, not only in this iron, but in any iron. And it's key for you to find out maybe what those break points are as to what type of head you should be going for. And that is the advantage, I think, of the 6.5 approach, is that these three sets are really designed to come together as one. And I think for me, even as a low single figure player, six is where the change should happen, because it was proven that it was just more consistent for me. And that is really what iron play is about. It's about being consistent. So let's see how this one feels. Now, it does have maybe a fractionally sort of more hollow sound to it. The feel is still very good. It feels very powerful. It doesn't really launch it a lot higher. It is feeling very forgiving. And then from the six iron upwards, you also got these tungsten toe weights, which are there to really add more weight to the toe and really add to the effect that muscle creates as well. You can actually see them in the toe. To be perfectly honest, I'd rather not see them. I don't mind them being in there. I'd probably rather think that the fact I'm hitting it super straight is more to do with my own skill than because there's some technology helping me. Or maybe that's what I want everybody else to think. I'm going to move up to the 4-iron now. Again, I'm now still in the 5.65, and this doesn't look too oversized. You can't see the cavity at the back, so that's a good thing. There's a little bit of offset. It's got a decent sized head. Let's see how this one works. Again, I found it to be very consistent, and I found it to be quite a powerful iron as well. The rule, and maybe that's partly because, you know, you're getting a bit more forgiveness from it, but it really is an excellent driving iron. Overall, I really like the Z65 range of irons, and I like the fact that they're forged, that they're simple, but they give you that forgiveness and they give you that feel. And I think these are probably ones that are going to sneak under a lot of people's radar, but I really would urge you to try and seek them out and try them out. As you've probably seen here, the blending is really the way to go. I think depending on the level of handicap, you want to start with the 5.65 and the longer iron, 4, 5, probably 6, maybe even 7, and then you can switch into the 7.65s for some of the lower clubs. Elite players maybe want to go for those blades, but I think really most of us would be perfectly happy with the blend of the 5.65 and the 7.65. Is that what you would do? It'd be interesting to hear your views. Please just thumbs up the video and leave some comments below. And for more videos, please just subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit the website, where we have over 1,000 reviews on all manner of golf equipment at golfalot.com.